How's it going, everyone? In this video, I'm going to be talking about four approaches for saving money while staying happy. So, most of us, I imagine, want to save more money, find ways to, you know, save up for a house or a car or a big purchase or retirement or all these different things, right? There's all these different value pieces that we get from having money saved up so that we can get some of these more important purchases locked down. But it can be difficult to do so. And I think there's a pretty common feeling of like, I want to save money, but I don't want to kind of exclude the ability to do the things that I want or to neglect myself or to not have the things that I value and that make my life good. So in this video, I'm gonna go over four ways to kind of start framing your mindset in a way that you can find balance between saving money and enjoying life as it is. Because, you know, on the one hand, money is nice and there are like long-term things that you'll want to put money into to eventually buy, like again, like a house, a car, investments, whatever else. But on the other hand, you never know how long you have, right? You never know, you know, if you save up all your money and then get hit by a car or something, then you've really not been able to use any of that value. So it's about finding kind of the balance of not feeling miserable, but still saving enough that you can hit these other goals. So the first step in saving money is to know where you are currently spending money, right? You need to know where it is that different amounts of money are slipping away or different buckets that they're going into. So you need some sort of system to track where your money is going so that you can see, you know, oh wow, I spent, you know, $1,000 on eating out this month. That's absurd. Or you can know, you know, oh, I have these subscriptions that keep popping up, or oh, I have this thing. If you don't know where your money's going, you're not going to be able to reallocate to save yourself any money. So that's the first step, is knowing. And there are a lot of automatic tools that will kind of categorize your purchases for you. So if you're using things other than cash, a lot of the times your bank will have some sort of tool. Otherwise, you can usually connect a bunch of things and get some more information you need to kind of categorize your spending. The second piece of knowing your expenses is kind of setting budgets for certain types of items, right? So once you know how much you have, how much you spend, then you can kind of look at, okay, this is about how much I should spend on food. This is about how much I should spend on transportation, et cetera, et cetera. And you want to build in a little bit of a buffer, because most months or every 3 months or however often, you're going to run into expenses that aren't normal and can't quite be calculated perfectly. So if you know those ahead of time, like, hey, every 3 months I have to pay for this, factor that into the budget you're setting, because it's gonna make it work out a little bit better because you know you have that expense, it's just not every month. Another piece of this that can be helpful is if you have the opportunity, if it works with whatever system you're using, set up automatic alerts or reminders for your budget. So, you know, maybe you can get a text when you get to your budget for food for the month, and it can just let you know, hey, you've spent, you know, as much as you're supposed to spend on food. And part of this process is kind of being incremental, right? Kind of learning about it and not really holding yourself to the utmost, highest, perfect standard, right? What you want is to kind of move in the right direction. You don't have to go from 0 to 100. You can, but a lot of times it's hard and we end up reverting. So use this first step, this knowing your expenses, as kind of the baseline that you build your other steps out of. You need to kind of know what's going on before you can make adjustments, but don't feel like you have to go and get it all done. Now, the second approach is to determine what's most important, right? Once you know where all your spending is going, you can kind of change in a couple different areas. So one thing you can do is cut out certain things. If you're spending a lot of money on something that isn't bringing you a lot of value or doesn't feel great, then you should just get rid of it. So let's say, for example, that you have a gym membership that you use once a month, and the rest of the time you go ride bikes, you go running, you go do things that you don't actually need that membership for. If you're not getting the value out of this thing that you're putting money into all the time, then it may make sense to cut it out. And you can also, you know, do this on a temporary basis, which is to say, like, maybe you cancel your gym membership for a month or two and see if it's something that you miss. See if it's something that you're like, I really wish I actually had that back. Because then that way you can see if that money is going into a place that's actually providing value. The second thing that you can do is to look for cheaper alternatives to things that you have that are really expensive. And, you know, in some cases you may trade off quality, but the idea here is to find things of roughly equivalent quality or what things that aren't, you know, actually degrading your quality of life that still provide that same level of benefit. So again, going back to, you know, this gym example, like maybe you're going to a really super high-tech fancy gym that costs $150 a month or something, and it offers, you know, all these training things and saunas and classes and whatever else, but you don't use any of it. Maybe you could look for a gym that is, you know, $20 a month, has a lot more bare bones offering, but it's the stuff you actually use. So again, it just goes back to this idea of once you know where you're spending money, kind of take some time to think about each of those items and the spending and how much value you're getting out of it. And some of the most common categories that you can kind of cut back on or adjust or change around without really lowering the quality of life, but saving money is food, subscriptions, and like coffee or alcohol, like drinks. Those things, a lot of time, there's some room in there to make some minor adjustments and really save a lot of money. There are, of course, a ton of other different, you know, categories like insurance commercials all the time. They're like, switch to us and save some money. That's a good thing to do every once in a while. So it's just about kind of looking for these alternatives, but in a way that doesn't sacrifice a ton. Now you can, if you have really aggressive goals, you really need something that you have to buy, or there's something serious going on, then you can more aggressively, you know, really give stuff up. But I want to present this video in a way that you can save more money without, you know, impacting your happiness negatively. And to some people, that's what happens when they start giving up all kinds of stuff. On the other hand, sometimes what happens is you give up stuff and you realize like that wasn't really adding anything to my life. It was expensive, but it didn't make my life any better. Now, the third piece of saving more money is to automate the process as much as possible. If you can make it so that your money goes into these other accounts without you ever thinking about it, without you ever touching it, that is the ideal scenario because it's much easier for, you know, your paycheck to come and get split automatically to like 10% in savings or whatever else and the rest in your checking than it is to go all into your checking and then later go through and move the money, right? Every time you have to move the money, you have to make the choice of, oh, do I want to do this? Is this right? Do I have the money for it? Et cetera, et cetera. When it's automatic, it just automatically goes in there and then you don't have to think about it. You know that it's gone into the correct place. And for most setups, most situation banking, you can set that up for savings or investing, you know, some percent of money to come out on a certain time schedule automatically. And that pretty much guarantees that you will be saving. So if you have that first step, you know your expenses, you know your budget, you know how much you can get by on, then you can, you know, set up some amount that comes out. And then, you know, if you have some sort of emergency or whatever else, you can always reverse it and get some money out of your savings. But that way, the default is to save as opposed to the default is to keep it in your checking, where a lot of people are more likely to spend their money. They're more likely to look and say, oh, I have this money, I might as well spend it. So automate as much as you can if you can. Now, the fourth approach to saving more money, and this might seem a little bit like cheating, but it's to actually make more money and then not have lifestyle inflation. So there are definitely situations where people are spending the vast majority, if not all of their money on things that are pretty much essential or add to their life. And if you're in that position, but you still want to save more, you know, I have to spend this much, I make this much, how can I save? Well, you need to make this piece bigger. You need the piece of what you actually earn to grow. So there's, you know, several different paths to do that. You can try to negotiate, you can build some more skills, you can look for new jobs, you can start up some sort of a side hustle. But the most important piece is to avoid lifestyle inflation, right? If you end up making an extra $5,000 a year and then you also end up spending an extra $5,000 a year, that doesn't get you anywhere with your additional savings. So what you have to do is, you know, again, figure out whatever your budget is, figure out however much you're spending, and then say anything past that amount is going into my savings, is going into my investments, or whatever else. And that way, you're not going to just keep spending more and more and more as you continue making more money. Now, this, you know, probably sounds a little bit like, oh, yeah, easier said than done. You just go out and make more money. And, you know, there is some truth to that. There is some difficulty sometimes in just increasing your income, but it is one of the paths that are open to quite a few people, and quite a few people can expect raises of certain amounts on a certain time frame. But it's very, very common for people to make more money and spend exactly the same amount more. And as long as you find some sort of path to make what you're spending less than how much it's increasing, you're going to increase your savings rate. So by that I mean if you get a raise for $5,000 and you want to spend a little bit more, maybe you only allow yourself to spend $2,000 of that, and then you get that extra $3,000 in savings. So those are four ways to kind of start thinking about how you can save more money and ultimately end up with the lifestyle that you want, retaining your happiness instead of, you know, giving up a bunch of stuff in order to keep as much money as you can. Because again, money is only worth something when it's used. So you need to kind of find that balance between saving money and actually getting value from the money that you've earned. As always, I want to do a couple of reflection questions. One, where do you spend the most money? Two, where could you cut back on spending? Three, what's one way you could increase your income? Four, what's one way you could automate your saving process? That's all I've got for this video. So hopefully it gives you a few ideas, a couple starting points, a way to kind of frame these thoughts. Again, the most important piece is really understanding how much money is coming in and where it's going out to. Once you have that idea of kind of the flow, you can start directing the different streams of money in different ways and start looking at different options for balancing out the lifestyle that you want. That's all. So if you have any questions, comments, topics you want me to cover, throw them down in the box below and I'll get to them as soon as I can.
You can check out more content at howtohappy.com. Also, don't forget to subscribe so you can stay up to date on the videos. We've also got a Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook that you can check out. Reflect, take action, and enjoy life. See you next time.